Hello friends, in today's lecture we are discussing about Slack and its time. Slack, the term used in your construction project planning. Now what is Slack? Slack is basically, as you can see, T of an event is defined as the earliest time. Now T is not your earliest time at which an event can be expected to occur. If you draw an activity, so we have tail event and we have head event. So tail event 1 and head event is your 2. So now what is basically T? T is the earliest time at which the event can be expected to occur. Means it is the earliest time at which we can start that particular activity. So activity A can be start at 2 days. So at your second day we can start with activity number A, that is known as TE. And TL, what is TL? So TL is the latest time at which it can be allowed to occur without disturbing the project duration. Talking about a single activity, so T is your earliest time in which the activity can be occurred and TL is the latest time, late to late, when we can start that particular activity without disturbing the project duration. So two terms are there to identify the slack. We have to use these two terms for that particular activity, T and TL. So T, as early as we can start with that particular activity. Suppose the A can be start in 2 days and its TL is 4. What means that the activity A can be start after 4 days also. So after that we can delay it. So at 4th day we have to start the activity in anyhow conditions. So that is your latest starting time of the particular activity. If the difference between these two times of an event, it indicates that the particular event can be delayed by the difference without changing the project duration. So if you go for EL minus TE, so in this case it is 2 days, so the activity A can be delayed by 2 days. Because at the earliest it can be start at 2nd day, at the late it can be started at 4th day. So we have the gap of 2 days. So within 2 days we can shuffle the activity. We can start it at 2nd day or 3rd day or maximize 4th day. So this is the difference between two activities. So we have 2 days in between of this projects without disturbing the project duration, complete project duration. That is your slack. So this difference between the earliest expected time, that is T, and the latest allowable occurrence time, that is EL, of an event is called a slack of that particular event. So this is known as what? Slack for that particular event. So for each event, slack is different. I hope you understand. So T is your earliest expected time and TL is your what? Latest allowable occurrence time. So difference between these two times for the particular event, or event one suppose, is known as what? Your slack for that event. Finding out the slack of each event brings you to notice the relative urgency of that event. If the difference between two is zero, it means for it is very urgent. For example, suppose T is 10 and TL is also 10, it means what? There is zero slack present. It means what? We have to complete that activity, or we have to start that particular event at the given time only. There is no slack available. We can't delay that particular activity. Slack means the time is there to spare for that particular event. Simply slack means what? We have the time, so we can delay that particular activity. We can relax the resources over there. But if slack is zero, it means what? We can't delay that particular activity. Events with slacks are less urgent. It has excess resources attached to it, which can be trade off in case of any exigency. So we can use this particular resources for the other activity where the slack is zero and where the urgency is more to complete that particular activity within the expected time. So by finding out slack, we can identify which activities can be delayed, which are not that urgent, and which are allotted more resources, and these resources can be used for different activities. Even without slacks denotes potential trouble spots. So without slack, that means what? These are the trouble spots. So we have to be very genuine and we have to be very attentive to that particular activity, and we have to monitor it very precisely. Otherwise, what happened? Otherwise, your whole project will get delayed. And slack can be of three types. First is your positive slacks, zero slack, or the negative slack. So what is positive slack? Positive slack is obtained when TL, that is your latest allowable occurrence time, is more than T, that is your earliest occurrence time. It indicates the ahead of schedule. So the our condition is what? We are ahead of schedule. Is your slack is positive. Then talking about zero slack. Zero slack it obtained when TE and TL are equal. This indicates no schedule condition. So there is no schedule condition. We are going on a right track. And the last is your negative slack. Now what is negative slack? A negative slack occurs when TL is less than TE. So latest occurrence time is less than the expected occurrence time. That is your negative slack. This happens when schedule time of completion TS is less than TE. This indicates behind the schedule condition. TS is more total completion time, your project completion time, that is known as TS. And if your TS is less than your T, means what? Expected time, average expected time of completion, then this type of slack may occur, and it indicates what? You are running behind your schedule. So that negative slack will occur. So generally we are go for positive slack or zero slack. If there is negative slack, it indicates what? We are behind our project duration. So in this video we have seen what is slack and what are the types of slack. So there are three types of slack: positive slack, zero slack, and negative slack. Thank you.